Hey guys, welcome to my channel. In today's video, we are going to be starting with question number 5 for exercise 1C from chapter number 1, Rational and Irrational Numbers for class 9 ICSC from the book Frank EMU Books. So, the question says expand, and the first question or the first sub-question under this question is going to be 2 plus root 5 the whole square. Now, looking at this identity, you can say that the identity being used here will be a plus b the whole square. So we write down the formula first. A plus b the whole square equals a square plus 2ab plus b square. Now we know that 2 is our a and root 5 is our b. You can mention that if you want, but I don't think that's necessary over here. Now we write 2 square instead of a square plus 2 into 2 into root 5 plus root 5 the whole square. We write 2 square as 4 plus 2 twos of 4, and root 5 will be written as it is because it's not having any into root 5 again to make it just a 5. Plus we have root 5 the whole square. Now root 5 the whole square will come down to 5, as we can write root 5 the whole square as 5 square into 1 by 2, or 5 raised to 2 into 1 by 2. Now the 2 and 2 will be cut, so we'll get 5 raised to 1, that equals 5. So we are going to have 5 over here. We add 4 and 5, 9, plus 4 root 5. So the answer will be 2 plus root 5 the whole square equals 9 plus 4 root 5. Let's move on to the next sub question. Here we are having the second sub question as 7 minus root 3 the whole square. Looking at the question, you know the identity used will be a minus b the whole square. It's a square minus 2ab plus b square. So 7 is our a and root 3 is our b. Instead of a square, we write 7 square minus 2 into, instead of a, 7, and instead of b, root 3. Plus, instead of b square, we write root 3 the whole square. 7 square will be 49 minus 2 sevens are 14 will be written, and root 3 will come as it is because, as I explained in the first question, there is nothing to make it a whole number. Plus, root 3 the whole square will become 3 from the same logic as root 5 became 5. Now, 49 plus 3 minus 14 root 3. That will be 51 minus 14 root 3. And that is the answer for 7 minus 3 whole root 3 the whole square. Let's move on to the third sub-question. So, the third sub-question says 2 root 3 minus 5 root 2 the whole square. The identity here will again be a minus b the whole square equals a square minus 2ab plus b square. So 2 root 3 is our a and 5 root 2 is our b. We write it as 2 root 3 the whole square minus 2 into 2 root 3 into 5 root 2 plus 5 root 2 the whole square. The 2 root 3 will be 2 square 4, and root 3 the whole square will be 3. So 4 into 3 minus 2 twos are 4, 4 fives are 20, and the numbers under the root sign that are 3 and 2 will be multiplied. So we'll get 20 root 6 plus 5 root 2 will be 5 square as 25 and root 2 the whole square as 2. So these are 12 minus 20 root 6 plus 50. Now we write 12 plus 50 minus 20 root 6. So it's 62 minus 20 root 6, and that is the answer for this question. So let's write the final answer as 62 minus 20 root 6. Moving on to the fourth sub question. So guys, the fourth sub question says 4 root 5 plus 3 root 7 the whole square. The identity here will be the one that we use in the first sub question, that is a plus b the whole square equals a square plus 2ab plus b square. Here 4 root 5 is the a and 3 root 7 is the b. We directly write it as 4 root 5 the whole square plus 2 into 4 root 5 into 3 root 7 plus 3 root 7 the whole square. Now we write them as broken down answers to be 4 square is 16 and root 5 the whole square is 5 plus 2 fours are 8, 8 threes are 24 and 7 into 5 we'll write it under the root sign plus 3 square will be 9 into 7 root 7 the whole square will be 7. Now we write it as 80 plus 24 root 35 plus 63. 80 plus 63 will be 143 plus 24 root 35. And that is the answer for this sub question. Writing the final answer, it is 143 plus 24 root 35. So guys, that's it for today's video. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe if you found this video helpful. And comment down below for any more suggestions. Thanks for watching.